So, this is Shroud of the Avatar, and we find ourselves in Desolis, and the dungeon in front of me is the Epitaph. Let's go explore it. I've already done all the quests inside it that I know of, but nothing's like exploring a dungeon just for kicks, seeing what loot we can find, monsters to kill. So, we'll head on in. Epitaph's definitely more of a medium-sized dungeon, I'd say. It's not super big, but it's definitely not as small as some of the sewers. Sewer dungeons out there. So. When you see these loading screens, I want this scene right here. I want to play this scene. Kill the big troll, somehow get the drawbridge down. That'd be great. And it might exist, and I just haven't seen it yet. Alright, so we're inside the Epitaph. As soon as you come in, none of these guys are hostile. In fact, the only one that has a name, I believe, is him. I've tried talking to many of them. Yeah, and they all give the same thing. None of them give me quests either. Fresh meat, eh? Secret of knowledge. The dark ones. You don't want to give me help? So, quests? No quests. Now, just because you ask for quests and they don't give you quests doesn't mean there's no quests. Sometimes keywords can open up quests. Either keywords that they say or keywords from other things. But in this instance, I'm sure he doesn't actually have any quests. Alright. So we can go all the way down to the bottom. There's two ways to get down. This first way, or the second way. And they both lead at the same spot, just slightly different positions. We get down there. But while we're in here, let's loot it. Let's loot it up. Open both doors. I figure, why waste perfectly good, gold and whatnot. I'm going to take all these. Even though they have no value as far as selling to an NPC, you can still salvage them for parts, which is very nice. If I can grab it. Of course, you don't have to right-click. You can simply drag and drop. So I just get used to right-clicking on stuff. All right. Some gold and scraps. I haven't yet found anything in any of these things worth worrying about. That could be hidden doors in there or whatnot, but I haven't seen any. And we don't need to take all the stuff. I don't need a pewter jug. Nothing in the sack. Try this sack. Some other boots. I'll just take up all the junk too. So even if it's broken, you can still sell it. Thanks, bud. Cave Fables 3. I'm pretty sure I have that book. I try and collect the books I don't have. Let's take that, that, and that. We'll take the last book just in case I don't have five. And you can easily fill up your inventory with all this stuff if you're not careful. So, and it's not too bad, it just slows you down a little bit. So, but I've got an obsidian potion going. I've got an obsidian potion going. I got some pretty good skills increasing my weight. carrying capacity. No way. I'm telling you, it's a rusty sword, but it looks like a scimitar, rapier. Well, it doesn't look like a scimitar in this game, but it looks like kind of like one. Or a cutlass, maybe. Can I grab that? Oh, I can't grab that for some reason. Alright. More stuff. Yay. It's all mine. Take all this. Now this stuff will start weighing down. Now you can actually use this equipment if you really, you know, really needed to. You could use some of that equipment. So. Take the candle. That's not. Alright. Just 12 gold. Alright, and I believe I have all these books, so I'm not gonna bother looking through. But a lot of this stuff respawns if you stay here long enough, so you could just collect all this stuff and then melt it down or for scrap. If you really wanted to. So there's the door to the other entrance. We're gonna skip that and go down the main one. Can't break that. Hear something? Yeah, you did. It was me. Stealing all your stuff. Alright. Let's zoom out a little bit. I don't like being so close. There we go. I'm gonna jump a little bit, level up my falling skill. There you go. Yeah. This skill lets me, safe fall. Lets me fall a little bit farther, or without hurting myself. Obviously, if I jump down there, I'd probably die. But every little bit helps, right? Dang. And I just got that skill, so that's why it's leveling so quickly. Alright. Didn't really see anything back there. We could go. That's the other way down. There's some copper nodes. If you look, there's something right there. Might be a mission item for something. I don't know. Alright. Yeah, slime. I hate slimes. We're not gonna go get that iron or that copper because I really hate slimes. And they start off with their, you know, the one state one, which is like the big, you know, big slime that does a little bit of damage. And then when they get to 50%, they split to two. Each of those gets 50%, they split two more times, so you have four total, but they all do the same damage, so now you've got, you know, four times the damage from one slime, and they hit you every second that they touch you kind of thing, so it's very frustrating. I really, really don't like it. Now all the enemies here are going to be well below my, adventure level, which is kind of a level system, like a level, but kind of a compilation of all your skills give you the adventure level, I believe. So yeah, most of the enemies in here are going to be green to me, maybe yellow, but I'm going to use more experience killing them than I'm going to gain from them, which is fine, because I have 50,000, 50.5. So, we're good. Alright, now that the stairs I was down. This goes off towards those slimes, that direction, and there's a whole other set of the dungeon that way. We'll do that part after. Let's go down this way first. Strength on. Kind of like I don't need to use these, but I don't mind. Level them up if I don't need them. Alright, we've got a door here. Right? Should we go straight or should we go through the door? Let's go through the door. So, a whole other hallway. Now, this is where we probably get lost and stuff. I'm really good at getting lost. Okay, let's go this way. What do we find in here? Alright, so it's just a room. Let's put the sword away. Guess we'll just loot everything. Can't like that. Now, again, you can take all this stuff, and some of it might have value. Some might not. Oh, look. I don't know if you can see that. secret door. There's a button. Buttons are often, like, they always seem, more often than not, are on this side, and they're usually, like, right here. So that's what I got, you know, but sometimes they're off to the side, or they're on other walls, or you have to click other things. So, lots of books here we could look through, but we're not going to. So let's see what we got here. Just a little spike, oh, full weapons, and 100 durability. Nice. They're generic, they just say a long sword in Warhammer rather than copper long sword or whatever. But the advantage to weapons like that is that you can enchant them. Or sell them for more value than, you know, cheap weapons and stuff. So, alright. Underdweller. Quite a bit of hit points. But obviously it's not gonna matter. Inside a cave and stuff, you carry gold around with you. Okay, let's take that. Oh, haste potion. Nice. Can't grab this. Darn. Grab those bowls. Those books. What do we got here? I already have those books, but I'm going to take the dagger and the rug. Thank you. Back there. Alright. I guess. Just keep exploring. It's a dead end. Big giant room. Well, again, if you want to decorate your house, here's a lot of dishes. Oh, here we go. Cabinet, nothing. Let's take it, thank you. No, I don't really see much of anything around here to take. And I'm not gonna bother stealing or taking all the crap that's probably not worth anything. Some boots. Great place for boots. Now, there could be something on the floor or on a chair or on a desk or something that's easily missable, so. Break any of this stuff? No. More books. Can't break anything. Door. Can't break anything. Nope. I don't see any hidden walls. Can't use the sacks. Nope. Alright. So that's the way we came. That's that end. Let's go this way. Down. Another room. Can't open any of these things. Funny because these are chests sometimes and other things. Why they would duplicate all these chests and not let me open them. Very frustrating. Alright, so we can go downstairs. Over. Here. I can check the cabinet. Some more gloves. Cabinet. Helmet. Alright, nothing else in here. Right or left. I'm really good with my right left. Alright, go straight. Now the door's open, so that means that we came down here, right? Yeah, there's the closed door. Did we come here? Maybe we went this way. Right? I think we did. Is that just in here? No. Some leather boots. Some scrap. Nothing here. We've looted everything we can. Go back through here. So basically, we've kind of finished that direction, is what it looks like to me. So let's go this way. Wait, that goes down. I'll go this way. stacking abilities mostly. These guys obviously aren't a threat. That pause is a recording issue. Because I'm recording directly to hard drive, so it's probably freaking out on me. Let's see, can I take that? No, nope. I can take all the books, but we're not going to. Mysterious notes don't actually have anything. If you click on them, it just says hastily scribbled, so they don't have anything of value. Unless I'm missing something personally that I don't know about, but I don't think so. So can't take anything else. The webs. That usually only means one. Oh, yeah, giant spiders. Oh. Well, they are giant spiders, but they're, at least they're small giant spiders. Gotta move them over here. If I can hit them, there we go. Oh, they're dead. Okay. Stuck. So you can jump out of the if they put webs on you, you can jump out of them. Sometimes it takes more than one jump, but definitely can. So that egg sac will definitely, these eggs will open up and spiders will come out. And I really don't believe there's anything in here. Except for more spiders, which I'm not worried about. But I don't think there's anything. I mean, there's a lot of books, and there might be a book for a mission in here, or a quest in here. But you have to look through a lot of books to find out. So what do we got here? Mysterious note, sticky web, mysterious note, mysterious note, mysterious note. I believe they are all just mysterious notes. If it was it was something important, it would actually say it. So. And we are not checking every book. Alright, I remember I have been through this dungeon before, so I do know where some things are. Light on. Oh, spiders. Must have broke that egg. If you get too close to them, they hatch. Nice, I'm leveling up some stuff. Here we go. As we go. I think I'm going to 50 with that. To get that to 75%. Nice. Alright. Now, if you look, there's a hidden door here. Alright, and usually, like I said, to the right hand side, usually one of those two buttons, and look, it's right there. So, but not always. Most commonly, that seems to be where they place them all. Oh, hear that? Come merging in. Rawr. Finish him off with a basic attack, but I keep missing somehow, even though he's right in front of me. That's hilarious. Alright. Again. Chest. Do I see anything else? Alright, we'll start in this corner. There's the door. I'm not sure, is that two separate sacks? One sack. I don't know. bottom sack. Open out middle sack. If it's separate. See, those are two separate sacks. Candle and leather boots in the top sack. Didn't have anything in it. Alright. Or maybe. I don't know. Either way, we will just continue to loot stuff. I have plenty of inventory space, I believe. Yep. We're good. Are we? And we're okay, I guess. And I'm guessing we are roughly halfway through the dungeon. If you can't figure out how to break something, just stand on top of it. I can't figure out where it's at. Take and eat this food if we want, but we're not really worried about it because you can't click on that. Over here. Spend more time looking through bags than we do exploring the dungeon. But it's worth doing. Because every once in a while you find really nice items in these things. Bottom sack. Yeah, I don't know if that's two separate sacks or one sack. Alright. Dead end. That's great. Okay, so we've explored this area with this secret area. Again, like I said, right side. Right there. Just always. Oh, I'm stuck in the lid. Okay. Alright, so. Some of these underdwellers might have spawned, respawned. Okay, that is very frustrating. Kill him with a body slam. It's not really much of a body slam, it's more like a charged knee or something. I'm guessing that pause is the hard drive saving from the video. Thank you. like I'm leveling stuff, even though I'm missing. Let's see what we got here. What at this level? Yeah. Seems to be having more and more, that slowdown. That's a new skill I just got, stun resistance. 26 8.1. That's like a jar of. No. Sometimes you can get a jar of worms or something. Anything in here? Some papers, mysterious, nothing. Nothing really to loot. Alright, other side. What do we got? Probably more mysterious notes. And some books. What do we got here? Cadric the Stag. Let's take that. Sorcerer's Daughter. Monkey and the Dolphin. The Lion Tattoo. Blessing or Bane. Hey, where's that Blessing or Bane one? The middle one, I think. Let's take it. Just in case. If it sounds like something I already have, then I keep it. Or I don't bother, but if it's something that sounds like I don't have it, I'll take it. Alright, so nothing. More books that I want to look through. Cabinet. Ooh, what's craps? Alright. So it looks like that's all this room, or this area was a living quarters. For that. Might be interesting. Or it could be complete gibberish. That'd be funny. Just to mess with people who want to try and read it. Especially if they were all unique. I don't think they are, though. Based on the watermarks here and here. Got it here and here. If you look at it, you have like XRP kind of thing. So yeah, definitely not unique. Or yeah. Alright. He's only yellow, but I doubt I can kill him. 2,000 hit points, that's a bit high. And he's a troll. So we'll see what we do. I don't want to die right here.
I don't want to die.
I can take you. I don't need help. Oh yeah? I think so. Nope, defensive. So I'm like barely hitting it. Not doing too bad, I guess. Oh, what's he doing? Oh. He's knocking me down. He's gonna do it again. Oh. Nice. So, I don't think I can kill him, and this is not looking very good. There's an exit that way. So I got 400 hit points. It's a good thing he can't follow me through here. Alright, let's heal up real quick, and then we'll go loot those chests. And then continue on through the dungeon. Bring on. friend in here to finish this one off. Come on. I might as well spam some abilities. Uses a little bit of focus, but I will also level up some skills. Passive deck to show up. There we go. You can only open stuff if you have your passive deck on. Oh, not good. Not good. On rocks. I think that's it. Yeah. If you look at the edges, there's really nothing. Nothing else. Alright. So. Yeah. I think we're through that room. Let's go this way. I'm guessing that's lava and we don't want to jump into it. We can jump into this though. Actually, this is the pool of destiny. So, unless I think that's what that is. Alright. That's all that has. I guess we go back up. Alright. Chamber of the laboratory chamber. This is where another one of the quests, well, one to two quests depending on how you look at it, is. I say that because there's a quest that you can do where you need to find something. And they're in this area, but there's two people that give you two separate quests, but it's this. But they want the same books or this. I just told you they want the same thing, and if you But if you give the items to one person, you can't give it to the other person. So you can only get the reward once from one or the other. So, all right. Yeah, spoiler. Looks like we got a couple $100. We're gonna loot the heck out of this area. This area is actually pretty good. I've done this several times in this area. And the loot is, some of the items you can get are worth a decent amount of money. So. Alright, so there's really nothing in the center section that I have found. Maybe there's something secret, I don't know. Up on top of these things, there's nothing. So what you really want is this stuff in here. These sacks. Now if you're lucky, this is crafting material. Lucky. Let's see if we'll get anything good. So nothing really major on that one. So that was the west entrance. I'll skip the doors for now. And, you can, if you needed a mortar and pestle. To do alchemy, you could take this one and use it. It's a station, just a regular alchemy station. Bunch of junk. Some more crafting. Now we're really hoping to get, we'll see if we get it, but it's really one good item. This is definitely, this is the exit to the rest of the dungeon. I know because of this stuff right here. And opposite of that is where we came in. Alright. not necessarily rubies, but any sort of completed gem. Those are worth, as you can see, they had a nice value. Where the hell did that guy come from? He's hanging out in here. Or he jumped out of the cabinet and like, I'm gonna wait in here until someone comes in. It's going to happen. Reason I'm going to go on this one compared to the other one is this one has nothing in it except for the one guy. You can't get into the cages, or the cages, I guess, or the cells. And there's no items or anything in here. At least that I've ever noticed. So, I'm just kind of looking around for kicks. The only thing interesting is this one, you see a giant skeleton. Sorcery gem recipe. Alright. And another more stuff. Alright, so this is where we came in. Right there. And when we open that, when we want this one. That's where we came in. That's the rest of the dungeon. That one over there was just the prison cell room. Skeleton, that was obviously, or skeleton, dragon looks like, that was obviously chained up in here. So crafting tables, this one's actually a plus 5. And then another book for something, I don't know what that's for. Then we go upstairs, let's see. Nothing. Let's round these guys up. Oh, wait, the exit was with this stuff. So. Trip him. Oh, dang, I missed. That's it, as soon as it's done. So we got this way, a big long corridor, and a giant vault. You can, if you jump down there, you die. I have tested it. I think this is the Well of Souls, but I'm not sure if that's accurate. That's just what I think it's called. I need to listen to the book again. The book that accompanies this game. And find out. So this guy right here, you talk to him. No matter what you do, he will not escape. He won't leave. He'll tell you that. But he does teach you... he does teach you the Belch emote. And he actually just did it. But, alright. Let's work our way through the rest of this dungeon. else in here. Alright. Work our way this way. Here's another room. Chest. Get lucky. Nope. Some meager amounts of gold. Alright, and we are in this section. So, from experience, this is the other entrance to the dungeon. So, not the dungeon, but this lower area. When we came down the big stairs, there was, we came down the main entrance, and then the slimes. This is the slime side. We stopped. And we will go up the slime side, just to, our little circuit. How did I fail? 90% chance. Obviously. This copper, there's three nodes in here. In this little section, from door to door, and they respawn relatively quickly. So you could, again, so you could hang out in here and just mine copper. Relatively quickly. It could be between these sections, whatever, but it's generally, not generally, it's always between this door and this door. So, alright, now we're just gonna run past all these guys. Again, I hate slimes. Copper and copper, but we'll skip them. There's an item on the floor right there, we'll ignore it. Double tap to run, and we'll just run up the stairs real quick. Alright, I'm gonna go pretty quick. We have plenty of focus, as long as I don't fall off. To get to the top. The door. As you can see, all this stuff respawned. Probably even inside these things. All the weapons and stuff respawn, so if you really wanted to collect them all again, you could. Barrels are still broken. I don't believe those ever respawn. So, we're back up top, and we'll work our way through out the main entrance here. And it's really bright outside. Transition. Alright, so that was the Epitaph and the Desolis. Kind of a medium-sized dungeon, not very big, but then again, not too small. Plenty of little interesting things. There's a handful of quests down here, as well as that. I don't think it's really a boss. The troll is not really a boss, but he's kind of a harder enemy for sure. And I expect there to be, even though through the quest that I just did, I expect there to be even more quests in there later on. As you can see, the city's not done. There's still behaviors and story elements that are to be added. So I think that they'll definitely be important quests in there later on. So again, that was the Epitaph.